You hear me all right?
Yeah.
Okay. All right, so this is math 132. Probably you know that. If you don't, well, you're clueless. Calculus 2. And what that means is that you should already be extremely familiar with derivatives and all of their aspects, and somewhat familiar with integration. You should know what an integral is. You should be able to do an integration by substitution, but don't necessarily need to know the more advanced techniques or the applications of integration and stuff like that. I know this is hard to see. I'm going to leave it hard to see because it's not... Well, maybe I'll dim the lights. So what we do in this class is all sorts of stuff about integration. So I will do a very, very, very quick review of what is integration, how to do it, that sort of thing. If you haven't studied any integration, then you're probably screwed and you belong in a different class. Or you need to be very smart, one of those two things. Because we're only going to spend about two, maybe three classes reviewing what is an integral and how to do basic integrations. Then we will slow down and we will focus on techniques of integration. These are things like integration by parts. And trig substitutions, partial fractions, stuff like that. Actually, stuff like that. And then applications, which is things, am I writing big enough for you guys in the back? Yeah. Things like volume, arc length, and maybe polar coordinates, stuff like that. That will take us through, well, you can look on the schedule and see that takes us through the first exam, which is on the 10th of October. No, sorry, the 6th of October. And then after that, we will seem to change tracks. We will talk about infinite series. And since maybe most of you don't even know what this is, I'll just put that aside for now. And then we will finish up talking about differential equations. Differential. And we won't do a serious in-depth study of differential equations. That's reserved for calculus 4 or math 303, 305, 308, one of those courses, or AMS 361. Anyway, that's reserved for another course, which is later. But we'll do a little bit of differential equations so that you'll get the idea of what differential equations are about and be able to use it in many of your courses. Probably the majority of you will not take the follow-up differential equations course. The number of people who take calculus 2 is about 8 times the number of people who take a differential equations course. So if you're an engineer, for sure you will take differential equations. If you're pre-med, probably not. Let me ask, so that's what we're going to do. If you know all that stuff, you don't belong in this class. And if you don't know differentiation, you don't belong in this class. And you kind of, sort of, well, anyway, whatever. So how many of you, I just want to get a sense, are freshmen? Okay, let me ask a different question. How many of you are not freshmen? Okay. Of those of you that are not freshmen, how many of you took Math 131 here? A couple. How many took AMS 151? Zero. Okay. All right, so most of you are freshmen, so you probably are not quite, familiar with Stony Brook and how we work things. One thing that is confusing and complicated, so before I start doing math, I want to talk about the structure of the class and what we're doing and so on. You may have noticed that I set up some cameras in the back. So the university has this system where they can make courses available. They film the lectures. This is done in, say, biology and a few of the chemistry courses and so on. It doesn't work well for math because you can't read the chalkboard. And this room is not equipped with the facility to record what's called Echo 360 or SB capture. On the other hand, I think it is worth having the lectures available. There is another lecture of this class that meets Monday, Wednesdays at 5:20, which will go do the same material. I'm not giving it, but my colleague and I work closely together. If for some reason you sleep late, you miss this lecture, you can go to her lecture. It's in the engineering building. We're going to cover the same time. Well, since we meet three times a week and they meet twice a week, in the same week we will cover the same material pretty much, but obviously we can't do exactly the same stuff in both lectures. But you can go to either one, provided that you can get in the room. Or you can watch these online once I make them and put them up. So these will start appearing on the webpage probably towards the end of the week, maybe early next week. Okay, let's see, I'm done with this. Many of you, some of you, may have gotten into Blackboard in order to get to the class page. Maybe you haven't been to Blackboard yet. I don't actually use Blackboard directly, I only use it indirectly. This web page is certainly accessible without logging into Blackboard by going to the math website. You can go to math department, calculus, M18132, that should be enough. Of course, you can log into Blackboard and just follow it from there too, because either way works. This web page, as you noticed, I put already on that page, I just link to it, but there's this link here that says schedule and homework assignments. I will update this as we go, so that if we fall behind or get ahead, I will change what we're covering when. But listed there is what we do each week. It's each week because one of the classes is 2 days a week, one of the classes is 3 days a week. And then as I make them, I will list the homework assignments and when they are due. And there's other stuff like we have a midterm on this day and so on. So you should look at this at least once a week. I will say more about it in just a second. So I guess I should say something about the exams and junk like that. So there are two midterms. And one important thing that is not obvious, especially if you are new to Stony Brook, they are at night. They are at 8:30 p.m. And they are on Thursday the 6th, October 6th, and Wednesday, November 7th. So that's a Thursday night and a Wednesday night. And there is a final, which is on December 19th at 8:15 p.m. So this is also, well, essentially the same time, and it's on December 19th. And then there's homeworks. So these are the things that you will be graded on. I'll say more about them in a second. But your grade will be based almost entirely, not completely, but by a huge amount, on your performance on the exams and the final. But the homework will count for part of it, the clickers, which I'll talk about in a second, will also count for part of it. But it is critical that you be able to be available these times. So if you work at night, or you live in New Jersey, or live in New Jersey and don't have a dorm room here, so you have a very long commute. Nobody's doing that, right? I had a student who tried to do that one time. It didn't work very well. You have to make sure that you're available on those days. You don't do makeups, so if you miss it, that's sad. If you miss it because you're hit by a truck and you are in the hospital, you can probably document that. And in that case, I will drop that exam and count everything else more heavily. If you are hit by a truck and spend the rest of the semester in the hospital, you probably want to withdraw from the course. But, you know, that makes sense. So there are, but if you miss it because, gee, there was a new Doctor Who episode out, and you had to watch that, or whatever, too bad. So if you miss the exam for a reason beyond your control, like illness, you can take account for it. If it was just because you were feeling tired that day, too bad, you get zero. Okay? The homeworks, these come in, so all of this stuff that I'm saying is detailed on this course description page. I'm going to say something about the text in a minute. But these guys are 25% each. This guy is 35%. The homework is 10%. And the clickers and partition are 5%. So of your grade, 85% of it comes from these things that happen at night. And then the remaining 15% is the homework. Don't think just because, oh, the homework is only 10%, what the heck, I'll blow it off, it won't matter. But you can get away with doing that, unless you already know all the material in the class anyway, which if you do, then why are you here? You cannot succeed in this class without doing the homework, not because of the grading issue, but because you won't be able to do the final, you won't be able to do the exams. You can't do math without doing homework. You may have been able to get away with it in high school, you will not be able to get away with it in college unless you are amazingly smart. I haven't met anybody who can do math without doing the classes. So it's important to do the homework. Let me say a few points about the homework. Let me say some things about the homework first. The homework comes in two parts. There's something online using a system called WebAssign. And then there will be, most weeks, one or two problems that you do on paper and turn into your TA in the recitation. The WebAssign problems, there will be more of them. There will typically be 15 to 20 of them a week. They are always due on Wednesday mornings. Don't think that means get up early on Wednesday and do your homework. That means make sure you finish it before you go to sleep Tuesday night. If you don't go to sleep Tuesday night, well then, make sure you finish it before. I won't even tell you the time it's due, because it's morning. Morning is a bad time for most of you, it's a bad time for me. And so do it before Wednesday morning. I strongly, strongly, strongly recommend that you begin it well in advance. You can print these things out, do the problems, and so on. I will go through a little bit about that in a minute. The WebAssign homeworks will cover the material that we've talked about in lecture the week before they are due. If you do the problems, so if it's due on Wednesday, if you do the problems 2 days before it's due, you get more points. So there's a bonus for each problem completed correctly early, so by Sunday night. The problems are graded, perhaps in a funny way. You type in the answer, it says right or wrong. If it says wrong, you get to type in another answer. However, if you get it wrong, if you get it right the first time, you get 1 point for that problem. If you get it wrong the first time, but get it right the second point, you get second time, you get half a point. If you get it right the third time, you get 1/3 of a point. If you get it right the 10th time, you get 1/10 of a point. So there is a diminishing amount of credit awarded. So it's better to answer the question once you've worked it out rather than just make a guess. Now, I said, well, but you get a bonus on the, well, whatever, I said about the bonus. Okay? If you have, well, yeah. If you have, it, so what I recommend you do is look at all of the problems during the week in which they are assigned. They will always be available to you for at least 1 week, typically for about 10 days. So I would suggest that you look at the problems now. Don't necessarily do them now, but you know, go to WebAssign, look at the problems that are due next Wednesday, say, oh, I can do that, I can do that, I can, oh, I don't know how to do that. And then those ones that you don't know how to do, you can help them. Yeah. That was really a dumb thing to do. Okay, as if you've already done that, you've already blown it, you already got 3 points on the assignment out of 20? You got a lot wrong.
Not a lot.
Okay, well, eventually you don't get much points for that one question. So, these questions are worth 1 point. There will be around 250 of these questions, or 200 questions over the course of the semester, and total, that 250 points or so, is worth about 7% of the grade. So, getting one question wrong is not the end of the world. Getting even one a zero on one assignment, not the end of the world. So the point of the homework is for you to learn how to do the problems. When you are learning, you will make mistakes. When you were learning to ride a bicycle, assuming you learned how to ride a bicycle, you fell down a lot before you mastered that. When you were learning to drive a car, you probably, maybe you crashed into a few things when you learned to drive a car, or you at least drove funny at the beginning. Part of learning is making mistakes. So it's okay to make mistakes. The reason for the penalty there is to stop you from guessing. Because, I mean, I've been doing this for several years now with online homework, and if you just let people, I mean, obviously I want to give you several tries. It's one of the big advantages, but also, if you just guess, you won't invest any effort in doing it. You'll just say, oh, looks like three. Nope, wasn't three. Oh, maybe it's four. Nope. So, I want you to think about it before you do it. So, the fact that you lost a few points here and there is not a big deal. If you completely trashed your assignment, you can ask about it later. Okay? There is a facility in WebAssign. There's a button that says Ask Your Teacher. So, if you're doing a problem and you think it's right, so. There are a few subtleties in there, but you can ask for, you know, something's wrong with this. I know it's right, but it says it's wrong. Please fix my grade. That goes to me. That goes to your TA. That goes to the other instructor. It goes to several people, and some of us will respond. Keep in mind that we are not sitting on WebAssign 24/7, and if you ask a question and somebody doesn't answer in an hour, well, you're just being impatient. Maybe you'll get an immediate answer. Most likely, it will take a day or two. So that's another reason for doing your assignment early. Another comment about WebAssign. You have to pay for WebAssign. I'll discuss the paying in a minute. If you haven't paid for it, you get to use it for 2 weeks from Monday without paying for it. But after that, it says no. So when you first log in, it will say, hey, do you want to pay? I strongly recommend you wait to pay until a little later, just in case you decide that this class is not for you, you want to do something else. Let me say something about the textbooks. How many people have purchased the textbook already? Oh, too bad. How many people have not purchased the textbook already? Good for you guys. So, let me say a few words about the textbook. The bookstore is charging an exorbitant amount of money for the textbook, around $190. I think that's crazy because they paid about $120 for it, but that's what they're doing. I have made arrangements, so those of you that haven't, with the publisher, they have about 300 copies that they will sell to you for $142 if you buy it online, maybe $145. So you can buy the text online from the publisher and put a link on the website. It only went up there, so this works as the publisher here. Takes you to the publisher's website where you can buy the textbook for $142 plus tax, but I think no shipping. That includes WebAssign access. That's way cheaper than the bookstore. It's like $50 cheaper than the bookstore. So that's one option. Another option, if you don't actually feel you need to have a paper copy. Yeah. No. So the book may look like this. It may have a picture of the Earth on it. If it has a picture of the Earth on it, that's the Stony Brook edition. If it looks like this, this is the edition that every other university that's using this book uses. The only difference between them is this part here, the cover. The reason that we have a special Stony Brook edition is because we made a deal with the publisher that they would charge less. The problem is that Barnes & Noble decided that, well, we're paying less, good, more profit for us, yeah. So originally when we made this deal, we wanted the students to be able to get the book cheaper. Unfortunately, anyway, I'm not happy with the bookstore, maybe you can tell. Okay, so that's one option. Another option, you don't have to buy the textbook at all if you don't want to. You do have to get access to WebAssign, however. WebAssign has an electronic copy of the textbook available to it inside. You have to pay extra, but for $75 you can get WebAssign plus an electronic text. Another option, you can buy WebAssign without the textbook for around $47, and you can buy the third edition of the textbook, which is almost the same as the fourth edition. Used copies of the third edition are available for $5. So, I know for a lot of people money is an issue, and try to be sensitive to that. I don't know, is there anything else about the text? Okay. I tried to give you all of the options. It's a little confusing because there are many, but you know, you already dropped your $200, okay. The WebAssign access comes in a couple of flavors. One flavor is for one semester only, which is all you will need unless you decide not to pass this class. But the one that comes bundled with the textbook is multi-semester access. Because the textbook is the same textbook for Math 125, 126, 127, 131, and 132. So the little card that came with your textbook is actually many semesters worth of access. The $47 thing is one semester's worth of access, I think. And that also comes with an electronic text. So the little card that came with the book is an electronic text plus many semester access. Math 127 uses the same textbook, and I don't think they're using WebAssign, so if you have a friend who's taking Math 127, you could convince them to give you or sell you cheap their WebAssign card, or whatever. Any questions about textbooks or stuff like that? Yeah?
If I have another class with the same exam times,
you will not have another class with the same exam times. If you do, have that professor contact me and I will slap him over upside the head. There are occasionally a few things. So, university has this evening exam. We've had this evening exam business for 25 years. And these exams, I mean, there's a bunch of other classes that have exams at this time. They are all calculus classes. So if for some reason you are also taking Math 131 at the same time as 132, it's a dumb thing to do, but your exam is at the same time, and you'll be kind of screwed. But the only exams that should be given at that time at this university are calculus exams. There's another, you might have an evening chemistry exam, for example, but it's on a different day. You might have an evening physics exam, it's a different day. So, once in a while, it occurs that you're on a sports team, and they happen to be going, you know, to Florida that day. We can work those kinds of things out. Also, if you are registered for, if you have a disability, contact Disability Support Services. If you won't be taking the exam in the regular place, contact them. They'll contact me. We'll make arrangements. But for the most part, you should not have another exam. You may have another class. And if your instructor is such that he will not let you miss the class in order to attend the exam, he's being a jerk. But have him contact me. Yeah?
Does the WebAssign work for multiple classes?
I'm sorry?
Does the WebAssign access work for multiple classes, or do you have to buy separately for each class?
It works for every class that uses this textbook, which is calculus, and that's it. So if you were in Math 131, then the WebAssign will work for Math 131 and Math 132. But it does, if physics is also using WebAssign, you have to buy a separate access for that, for theirs. So it's tied to the textbook.
Okay.
I don't know if they have some kind of a deal, I don't think so. Other questions related to that? Yeah? This is the fourth edition of the Concepts version. It has buildings on the cover. This, you may or may not believe that it's a building, but it's a building. Or the third edition of the Concepts, I'm okay with that. That one has a, well, it's more clearly a building. I think it's the, this is, I think, the Disney Center, and the other one is the one in Spain. Yeah, maybe. I don't know what it is. Anyway, or the Stony Brook edition has people going up the staircase. The other Stewart book has violins on the cover. We don't want that one. Can I see it? I think that's the other one. But it doesn't have the regular cover. No, it's the early Transcendentals. That's the other one. Well, depends on, you know, there's complications related to the book. The order of that book is a little different. Things aren't going to quite correspond. That should have a violin on the cover. I don't understand what the, doesn't matter if the first edition had violins. Anyway, there's also an, I didn't say, there's also an international edition of this book. It's about $75 paper. Okay, other questions about the text or WebAssign? Yeah, that's the correct one. So can I hold that up? So this is the one I didn't bring. This is the one that you would get at the bookstore. Okay, there will also be these paper homeworks. There's no paper homework due next week. One will appear the next time. Those are due. You have recitation, which is where you meet with the TA. How many of you have not yet met with your TA? Probably about half. Okay. The paper homework will be due at the second recitation, which will be either Thursday or Friday. The clickers. So I'm also going to be using, not today, but I'm also going to be using clickers in this class. You don't have to buy one. Many other classes at Stony Brook also use them. For example, physics, chemistry, biology, economics, psych. I'm not sure what else. Several other big lecture classes use them. So if you bought them, so they're not the same clickers that were used last year, but most of you weren't here last year, so it doesn't matter. I saw somebody with one. They're white. They're from Turning Technologies. The bookstore is selling them for about $50, maybe $60. They have a mail-in coupon for $15. And then they'll buy them back for like $20 or something like that. So, if you need it for another class, for sure get it. How many people have a clicker already? Most of you? Okay. So for those of you that do not have a clicker, but you do have a smartphone, or a laptop, or an iPod Touch, or an iPad, or a Samsung Pad, I don't care. Anything that can get a web page in this room, I will also, when I ask clicker questions, I will also allow you to answer via a web page. You cannot share your clickers, and you cannot share your smartphone. That is, if the two of you are both using a smartphone to answer the clickers, you both have to have separate devices, because I will look at the IP address where you come in from, and if two different guys answer with the same clicker, then I'll think they're the same guy. So you can't share them, nor can you share the clickers. I won't use clickers this time, but I will use them next time, so bring them to class. The clicker questions will go into this 5%, as will your participation and recitation and so on. Yeah, I'll do it when I do it. So when I ask a clicker question, I mean, it's just going to be this web page. Well, here, I'll show you. It's this web page. I haven't yet put a link to it, but there will be a link on this web page that says clicker. And there's something about clickers that you go to a little page. It says there's no question for you to answer right now. But when there is a question for you to answer right now, it will say, what's your ID number? And is your answer A, B, C, D, E, or F? And that's it. You know, since it's fairly simple, it's easy for me to write such a page. Is there anything else I need to cover? Yes. So the clickers you can register on Blackboard. You can use the same clicker for multiple classes, obviously. I don't think that if you have a friend who is in the 520 lecture, you can share the clicker. But if your roommate is taking physics and you're not taking physics, you can probably use your roommate's clicker. Okay. You can also register multiple clickers for this. Well, no, you can't. If you lose your clicker and get another one, you can register it and fix it up. But, you know, you may need to tell me about that so I can make grades really good. Any other questions about administrative stuff? Oh, I guess office hours. So there are multiple people teaching this class, and multiple people teaching recitations of this class is not absolutely huge, but there's about, 10 of us? 2, 4, 6, 8, 9. So there are 9 of us who are instructors in one capacity or another. You can go to any of us for help. Our office hours are not yet posted. Also, I haven't actually figured out the offices of these people. I will fill them in. We each hold, we are required to hold at least 3 office hours a week. They will not be the same 3 office hours. I will tell you what mine are very soon once I know all my other obligations. And once I know these other people's office hours, I'll put them up there. Again, you can go to any of them. These guys, I'm using guys, some of them are women, but these folks have 2 office hours in the Math Learning Center. The Math Learning Center is a drop-in tutoring place in the basement of the math building. It's open something like 10 a.m. to 10 p.m. Monday to Thursday, and then also, maybe not, I don't know, something like 10 to 10 Monday to Thursday, and then Friday it closes around 3 or so. There are usually between 1 and 5 tutors there, and you just go in there and you say, hey, I need help, and then somebody answers your question. You need to be a little patient. It gets busy, especially right before an exam. These people will also have another office hour not in the Math Learning Center. I will have at least 2 office hours in my own office, and probably one office not in the Math Learning Center, but in the undergraduate office of the math building. And you can come to any and all of those. If you can't make it to the office hours, you can also make an appointment. So the office hours are when we are supposed to be available. You can show up. If you can't show up at those times and you want to see me at a different time, you say, can I see you Monday at 3? And I'll say, oh, gee, I have something else then. How's Monday at 4? Okay, good. I won't say exactly that. Other questions about getting help? Yeah. The math building is, well, if we could go through this wall, right there. My office, if I could point through the wall, is right there. The Math Learning Center, I have to point through the wall and through the ground, and right there. Most of these people's offices are in the math tower. I think there might be a couple in the physics building, which is over there. Other questions? No. Oh, yeah. So to log on to WebAssign for the next week and a half, you can either go onto Blackboard, pull down tools, let me remember, or you can get to this page, click on the link. Well, actually, you can get to the homework page. It says homework 1 on WebAssign. You click that button. It logs you into Blackboard if you're not already logged into Blackboard. What's my password? Does anyone know?
Password.
No, it's not. Is that it? That's it. Okay. So this takes you into WebAssign. You'll see something that would look more like this. So the first thing it says is, hey, you didn't pay. You want to pay? And you can say, no, I got 11 more days. I'm not going to pay right now. If you do have the card and you want to spend the card, you click on this button that says enter an access code. The card says your access code is this. Away you go. So when you get sick of seeing this, hey, you didn't pay, then you put in your number sometime within the next 11 days. So you get something that looks like this. Shows you a picture of the textbook. There's a homework here. You can click on the homework and click on the homework. All right. Did I click on the homework? Oh. No. Yeah, there we go. Oops. I clicked way too many times and was sleepy. And so this is the homework assignment. There's some problems. If you do them wrong, so I'm not even going to read the problem. I'm just going to randomly put in some numbers. And I'm going to say, okay, that's my answer. It's going to give me 2 red X's that say no. 2 red X's that say no. Then I fix them. And eventually I will get a green check. When I get a green check, that's right, yeah. The number of points that I get for that problem shows up here. It will go down as I enter wrong answer, well, it won't go down because it's at zero. It will not go up until I enter a correct answer. There are also things here, like there's this watch it. It pops up a little video of somebody doing a problem very similar. Read it. If you have the online textbook, it takes you to the section of the text about it. You can do these things. You know, there's 20-some problems here. I would say what I recommend that I do, most of you do is somewhere there's a print button. Click the print button, print it out. I mean, it depends on what works for you. The questions don't change, but not everybody gets the same questions. So right now, my question number one has these numbers, 8.7, 7.9, 6.7, da, 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 da. If you pull up yours, you may have different questions. So if you say, well, my friend, the right answer was 7.6, and I put in 7.6 and it says wrong, probably because you have a different question, think about doing the problem instead. Another thing that, so many of the problems, they're symbolic answers. So if you click on it and a little palette like this comes up, this means that your answer may involve something like a pie or maybe a formula, and you can enter it by the palette or you can enter it by syntax. A couple of things I want to impress upon you. 1/3 and 0.333, as many threes as you want, are not the same. 0.333 is not 1/3. It's close to 1/3, but it's not 1/3. Pi is not 3.1415. It is pi. So if an answer, unless it says, give your answer to 3 decimal places, give the exact answer. If the answer is 1/3, you enter that as 1 divided by 3. You do not enter it as 0.333. If the answer is pi, you enter the pi symbol, which you can pull down from here, or you can just type pi. Because pi is not 3.14. Pi is an irrational number. I could start telling you some digits, but eventually I would either have to stop or pay it off. So all of these answers are, unless it says otherwise, are exact. Yes, we're out of time, right?
Yes.
We go to 10:30, so we're out. No, we go till 10:30. The next class is at 10:40. Sorry. It's been a while to remember what the times are. I was actually going to do some math today, but other questions? Yeah. It's okay. You probably not yet. If you want to send me an email or be patient, one or the other. So I will sync the rosters on a fairly often, but it's tedious because I have to go in and click 10 times, so I don't want to do it every day because then I'm just crazy. If you send me an email, I'll do it. Say, tell me your name, tell me your ID number, tell me your recitation. Other questions? Yeah.
So, this website is due next Wednesday.
That's correct. Which, unfortunately, probably I will extend it till Friday, which means that you have to do it by Wednesday to get bonus, because we kind of lost class day. In general, they were going to do on Wednesday, so the following one will still be on Wednesday unless we have another hurricane. So the idea, so I strongly recommend that you print out your WebAssign assignment, or at least read it, before you go to recitation. Especially for those of you that have Monday, Friday recitations, you will not see your TA before these things are due. That means you don't get to ask him questions. This one is on, everything on this is something you should already know. I will review it, but it's something you should already know. This assignment is on definition of the integral, that is binding areas and stuff like that. The fundamental theorem of calculus, which is the thing that says that the integral of a derivative is the original function, and the derivative of an integral is the original function. And a couple straightforward integration by substitution. So this homework assignment, there should be nothing new to you. Trying to think if there's other questions. I suggest, though, that you look at it. If you have any questions, you use your meeting with your TA to answer those questions. I will review them, but it's supposed to be reviewed. So you should be able to do these problems already. Other questions? Yeah. No. Yeah. How many chances? I think 10 for each one. After 10, you're getting less than a tenth of a point. So I think I set it at 10. More chances than you should need. Okay, you can do it that way. It's more that each time you enter a wrong answer, you don't get any points. But if you try several times, you get fewer points than if you do it right the first time. So it doesn't take points away, but you start with 0 points. So it won't give you negative points. Other questions? Yeah. I'm sorry? No, the recitations are not canceled for this week. This is a persistent but false rumor. Recitations meet. Sometimes they meet and they say, "Hey, I'm your TA. My name's Bob. Okay, see you next time." But you should go. Other questions? All right, so I'm going to end 5 minutes early because it's silly for me to start doing math now. We'll see you on Friday morning.